Well then, Agent York, do you have any plans for this evening?
I was going to head back to the hotel and go over my notes. I need to contact HQ and give a progress report too.
Okay, and let's call it a day here.
Sounds good.
Contact my office when you finish your report. We'll pick you up tomorrow morning. Diane, the owner of the art gallery, should be back soon.
All right then, let's do that.
Hold on, Agent York. We're going out to eat at Nick's Diner. Would you like to come with us?
The diner? That might be nice.
Thomas is a great cook, but Nick is the real deal. No visit to Greenvale is complete without eating at the A&G.
A very appealing proposition. Zach, what do you think? We can always go back to the hotel after eating dinner. Or go directly back to the hotel. You decide, Zach.
Mm-hmm.
I've been sheriff here for a long time now, and this is the worst murder I've ever seen.
Our town is a little odd in some ways, but it's usually a peaceful place.
We had our fair share of cases, but just the regular stuff. A high school kid shoplifting from the milk barn, maybe? Or some hot-headed kids fighting, fueled on liquor? Nothing more than that.
Agent York, what kind of cases have you dealt with in the past?
Not much different from those you've just mentioned. The case I was on until last month, well, the guy killed 7 girls in a 3-month period. He sawed their heads off from the neck and took them back to his house. He cleaned the skulls up and used them as utensils in his daily life, to eat from or as a urine cup. He hated women. That was his way of dealing with it. He'd fill skulls with ice, cola, and rum. Then he'd down it in one gulp. For him, that was a holy ritual. The question of his mental state was the pivotal point in the court case.
Oh, man.
For me, he was insane. 100%. Drinking from the skulls, well, that is one thing, but those he had used to relieve himself, he would then just use them to drink from, too. Yeah, that was too much for me. It's just not sanitary.
Not sanitary? That's probably not the problem for most of us.
What else? Ah, yes. An ingenious law school student raped over 800 victims. That was a nasty one.
Thank you, Agent York. Now, let's talk about something else.
You don't want to hear anymore? That's a shame, isn't it, Zach? I was just about to get to the good part, too.
Sounds like you live in a totally different world. I mean, you're like an elite agent who just jumped out from a movie or something. In your eyes, we must look like we're just playing cops and robbers. Ugh, I give up. I can't compete with you.
Don't say that, Emily. The cases you have solved are all full-fledged crimes. A crime is a crime. Size doesn't matter. There is no big and small. Crimes always have a criminal and a victim. No victim will ever welcome a crime, no matter what its size. So, fundamentally, there is no difference in size.
Well said, Agent Morgan. We work day and night to preserve peace and order in this town. You understand that, right?
Of course, but still, I don't view shoplifting and Anna's murder as the same level of crime.
Me neither. I never even dreamt that such a thing could ever even happen in this town. I keep on expecting to see Anna here in this diner, waiting on tables.
Excuse us, Agent Morgan. We should have made dinner a more uplifting experience. Let's call it a night.
Okay. Good night, then.
Thank you. Thank you.